Of course.
Yes.
What?
Of course.
Why do all these towns have to be so irritating to navigate around? At least give me some more jump points. Anyway, since I'm probably going to be exploring this and trying to just get this map up to 100%, might as well give a couple of my thoughts of the game up to this point. I am aware that this is only the first arc, and after this, it's pretty much free roam with a lot more post-game content. And there's also a New Game Plus mode, so I might dabble in that a bit. But, yeah, I enjoyed the game up to this point. The content amount of content in there is really overwhelming, especially once you get out of the hometown. You realize that there's a time limit, and since the game doesn't really give you a hint of exactly how long it takes you to do everything, it's a little bit hectic at first. I know I wasted probably way too much time for my own good in the first little bit trying to get 100% exploration. I only have 87 days remaining, and I've missed quite a bit. There's at least one area over here. I'm assuming there's probably something that leads here. Supposedly something over there, I don't know. And definitely this probably leads down there. And I missed pretty much the entire snow area, so there's still quite a bit to discover. And I'll definitely be going back and getting all that done as well. When it goes into free roam, of course. At this point, I'm probably just going to rush the exam, see how far I can go with it. Hopefully I don't fail, which is why I made the second save. The combat? I like the system a lot more than Sophie. Instead of just relying on basic attacks and chain bursts, abilities actually matter, and you have a lot more control over the overall effectiveness of your abilities, so yeah, that's nice. And oh, it's a ghost. So yeah. As far as the exploration aspect and gathering, that's all pretty cool. Having everything scattered around, and instead of more of a Sophie, here's a world map, and go here and gather this stuff. Well, this is a completely different design where it's just open world. Walk around, pick up whatever you want. But
that's done.
It's just my opinion, but compared to Sophie, there's a lot more trash in this game, and since you do not have 5,000 slots, it gets a little bit difficult. You saw me throwing out a ton of clay in the first couple, like 2 hours, because I just knew it would be trash, but that's fine. It just makes inventory management a little more daunting, which is also fine.
I tried.
So, it is a lot of fun. It is a lot of fun. I'm not sure what else I'm supposed to say. So far, I'm not in despair difficulty, but so far the battles, up until anything branching from here, they were fairly easy, as in you could just make bombs and cheese absolutely every fight, even on the hardest difficulty I could start off with. Which is a little disappointing, but with the time limit, I suppose it's fine. But yeah, cheesable fights. Even now I'm cheesing a lot of fights because the accessibility of those high power damage items is very high. Also, I didn't change my party. I'll probably be looking at what skills everyone else has, and hopefully they all level up with me, as like Sophie did, but if not, what can I do?
Yes.
Oh, Tia, that's cool. I did wish that they gave a little more, give us a little more idea of how long it would take to get wherever, but there is, I guess, some merit in just being like, oh, you have to rush, and that, like, I got caught in that trap, and now I'm here with 90 days to spare. I probably could have explored the snow area, gotten a lot more done, and I already did do a decent amount of backtracking already, so I suppose it's fine.
Coming.
Is there anything else I'm supposed to I can say? Well, obviously the game looks fantastic. The environments, because they're huge. I did read that expect gathering, quote unquote, expect gathering fields 5 times as large as those in the largest ones in Sophie, but it goes beyond that since it's entirely a massive gathering field. So it's a completely different experience, but another thing, the alchemy. That's a huge step up from Sophie, I think. Also because of the lag, it actually used to crash the game entirely. But being able to have a lot more control, I haven't been using the catalyst pretty much at all, but later when I need to optimize things, I'll probably think of using a lot more of those catalysts, see how far I can get with them. But for now, the basic ones are doing fine, unless I want to use that one that lets me duplicate items. So that's fine. But yeah, I like the alchemy a lot. Also, not having the items being duplicatable, I guess it's a thing. It was a very nice luxury in Sophie, but it felt a little bit overpowered, as in I could just make a really, really strong Sylvalia or something, have it duplicated 20 times, and there we go, I'd be able to forge my weapons to some insanity. I have not seen weapon forging here. I suspect there may be in the second arc. I have to make ultimate equipment somehow, right? But so far, the game paces itself very well, except for that little bit of a difficulty spike, and even then I'm still struggling a little. So there is that. But apart from that, the game seems rather balanced. The combat is quite entertaining, because having more than a grand total of 4 skills per character at maximum, and as well as a level cap that is not 20 grind until you get skill points, or ability points, or whatever, I like that a lot more. And instead of gaining 80 million stats per level, you gain like 2? So it's a lot more focused on alchemy to get the gear up to speed. I like that. I like it a lot. Although, it feels like I haven't done very much in terms of upgrading my gear. Just unlock a recipe, make it. Unlock a recipe, make it. So that's cool. And the story, I mean, it's an Atelier game. So obviously, it's just very lighthearted and fun. A lot of entertaining scenes, I suppose. I like the little tie-ins they have with Atelier Sophie, and I encourage you to play that if you're looking at this game first. Sophie was pretty entertaining as well, and knowing that there's a lot more post-game content in this game is very nice. So yeah, that's probably it. I don't have much more to say. So I'm just going to finish exploring the town, getting these things done, and then I'll probably just fire up the examination and see how far we go. Start up that second arc. So, yeah.
I have... What?
Ah yes, and the bonus content, the having more than like two costumes is really nice, for sure. And the massive DLC that just allows me to change the BGM for everything. I mean, I haven't thoroughly gone through everything, but there's a lot. It's really nice having, and the download was like 1.5 gigabytes, so there's a lot of music. That's all nice. I'm not sure if you can get it without pre-ordering or whatever.
Yes.
But yeah, it's a really nice piece of DLC. Definitely glad to have it. Also, I'm totally biased, which is why the battle theme is Cyclone, Ken Nakagawa, my favorite theme in the Atelier series. I'll shut up now and just explore. What are you doing?
Yes.
My. What material should I use? What material should I use? those here. I'll put this in the plate and start making it. Yeah, what traits should it have? Okay, it's done. Now, what to make? What material should I use? What should I make? What would be best? Is this my time to start the synthesis? This goes here! What material should I use? The exam location is the Reisenberg Government Office. Please arrive at least 10 minutes before the exam. The exam consists of a written test and two practical application tests. The following items are required: writing utensils, and materials to be used for synthesis, bombs and other items necessary for combat. Any cheating or fraud found during the exam will result in immediate failure. That's what it says.
I see. It sounds like there are more tests than expected.
Yeah. I need to at least make sure I don't forget anything. I get the feeling Edel would be really mad if I did.
You're right. Be careful, okay?
Yeah, I know. Anyway, now that I've read the important points, I just have to take the exam. If I pass the exam, I can stay outside for as long as I want. And then...
What's wrong?
Leah? What do I want to do?
Huh? What do you mean?
You know, after passing the exam, I haven't thought about that at all. Of course I want to stay outside forever, but... What do I want to do outside? What do I want to do with my life?
What you want to do? Huh.
Hey, Leah. Do you have anything that you want to do?
Of course.
Oh, really? Could you tell me?
I can't say it. Even to you, Firis.
What? It's okay, just tell me. Come on.
You want to know that badly? Okay, fine. Then how about this? If you pass the exam, I'll tell you what I want to do. That gives you at least one thing to do after passing the exam, right?
Oh, that's true. You're so smart, Leah.
Right? Also, I don't think you need to rush to find what you want to do in life. As long as you pass the exam, you can stay out here for as long as you want, after all. Isn't that right?
Yeah, you're right! Thanks, Leah! That was really helpful!
No need for thanks. It's a big sister's job to give advice to her little sister.